Good morning, students, and welcome to the English literature class. In today's class, we have a very good poem, poem number 4 of your literature book, The Beehive, The Late Isle of Innisfree. The Late Isle of Innisfree, written by famous poet William Butler Yeats. So, to begin with, without taking much time, isle means island, generally a small island surrounded by water, and within the island, the green plants, rich vegetation, and beautiful environment, peaceful atmosphere, sand around the shore. And the poet records that he used to be there, the Lake Isle of Innisfree. He used to go to this island Innisfree when he was young. So today, as he is a grown-up man, he recalls those younger days and he wants to go back again. Today he does not simply want to visit, but he wants to go and stay there and enjoy the beauty of the island, the atmosphere, the serenity, the peace of the atmosphere. So we find he imagines the island shore there and few vegetation there, and he wants to do certain things which are seen up there. So in this poem, the poet describes about his desire to be in that island in three stanzas. Let us go line by line. First stanza says this way: I will arise and go now, and go to Innisfree. I am a small cabin built there of clay and wattles made. 9 bean rows will I have there, a hide for the honey bee, and live alone in the bee loud plate. So he says that I will go to this island, and what I shall do? First, I will build a small cabin, a small hut, which will be made of clay, mud, sticks, wood, and next, I will cultivate some food plants, and he calls that I will cultivate rows of beans, a kind of vegetable plants, and I will have honeybee there, perhaps to enjoy the honeybee as well as enjoy the humming sound of the bee. Then he says, I will enjoy the open space, enjoy the peace and serenity, enjoy the breeze and being alone there, the solitude atmosphere. So this is what he wants to do in the isle. Second stanza, I shall have some peace there, for peace comes dropping slow, dropping from the waves of the morning to where the cricket sings. There midnight's all the glimmer, and noon a purple glow, and evenings full of the linnet's wings. The poet says in the second stanza that when he goes there, he will experience peace, and that peace comes continuously flowing to him from the surrounding. And that goes on from morning to evening, though during day some changes of atmosphere will be there. He says that he will hear in the morning and in the evening the sound of cricket, one insect. It makes beautiful sound. Then at night he will enjoy the starry night, the stars shining. He can see the moon shining. And during day, he could see the sunny day, sunny moon, the purple sun way more on the pavement way. I hear it. I hear it in the deep heart core. So he says, though now I am in the city, walking on the pavement of the road, but still I can imagine how the atmosphere in the island is. So he says, I will just get up and go now and spend the night and day there and enjoy listening to the sea waves sound, the sea water, wave water that flashes, splashes on the shore. That sound is very, very thrilling to the poet. And he says that now I no longer like to stay in the city. I want to spend my days in the island only. So this is the summary and explanation of the poem The Lake I Love Innisfree. I hope you got the clear idea about this poem. So thank you, students, for watching this video. Have a nice day.